alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadi alladhina istafa. Respected and lovely community, I hope all are well. And mashallah, may Allah bless you for giving your time. We are hungry, tired. It's Saturday. It's towards the end of the fast. It's a fundraiser. So these are all things that show if we're here taking part, that we really, really have some great sincerity and clear heart in regards to what we want to do with the Imam Masjid. I wanted to talk a couple of minutes, 3, 4, 5 minutes that we have about Maktab. It is an essential part of the community that our children are given an opportunity to get Islamic education. Now, why do they need this Islamic education in the form of a maktab? And when we say maktab, basically we're talking about a class that takes place anywhere from 5 to 6 days a week. Even some take place 4 times a week, anywhere from 1 to 2 hours a day. That is what a maktab is. The reason why we need maktab, and it's so important, is first of all, we don't realize that our children are in the environments of school for about 8 to 9 hours a day. Now, the environments in school, they are accommodating to, of course, education and all the things that they need, which are essential. But of course, they are not going to be accommodating at all for Islam. And if we are not doing the right things in our house, getting our kids Islamically trained, which many of us are not because we're working and we're busy, or maybe we lack the ability to do this. Maybe it's out of our laziness. Maybe we just don't have a good method of doing it. Maybe our kids aren't paying attention because they're too busy with the TV. And there's a lot of challenges. So it's important for our kids to at least spend some part of their day in an Islamic environment. And that is in the mosque, in the masjid, with a qualified teacher, whether it be the imam, whether it be a scholar, whatever it may be. Now, that's going to bring about two things in the kid. The kid is going to become adi. He's going to become habitual to going to the masjid, which very, very quickly, if we don't watch it, our children could be very, very unfamiliar with going to the masjid. So the child will already know what a masjid is and a mosque is. And also the child will have some ta'alluq and some connection and some relationship with the ulama and with the scholars and with the imam, which is very, very important. The second thing that is important in regards to maktab is hifdhul aqa'id, that the child is now protecting, or through the maktab, we are protecting the aqeedah of the child. We don't know whether the child will become a very practical Muslim after this. That's up to him later on. But at least we are instilling in the child their aqeedah and their beliefs. Aqeed in the Arabic languages come from the word aqt. It's something like a knot. We are tied to it. We're bound to it. So these type of things, as a child, when we're putting them in their brain, as they say in the Arabic language, al-hibzu fi sigr kanakshi fi al-hajr. You know, when you teach a child something when he's small and young, so it's like a scratch on a rock. It doesn't go away. So we are teaching the kid the very essential creed and beliefs, which a child knows, which will save him later on when he's challenged, when he goes out in the real world, when he goes out to college and does classes like philosophy and all these different things, or sees things on YouTube or on TV, or if he's challenged in the different environments he goes in, he will have these things in him, embedded in him from a child, which he'll stick to. I was mentioning to some of the members last night about a story of a lady in South Africa who attended the maktab as a child, but unfortunately, due to some tragedies in her life, she attempted the suicide from the top of the building, and she came off herself. They were, the police and officials were trying to get her off of the building, and she came off herself. And when she was asked why she came off the building, she said, "I remember my teacher reminding me about suicide and Islam and things like this in maktab when I was a child, and that was what I saw in front of me, and that was what made me come off the building." So of course, we hope that those scenarios don't happen to our children, but these type of things will assist our children later on. And the last aspect, of course, is the practical aspect. Inna ladina amanu wa amilu salihat. Our children need to learn their a'mal. They need to learn how to do the good deeds, learn how to do prayer, learn how to make wudu, learn the different aspects of Islam. So when the children do that, inshallah, it will be a very, very good thing for them as they get older and older, because later on in life, when they're 15, 16, 17 years old, they will not be humble enough and they'll be very embarrassed to ask people, how, teach me how to pray, teach me how to read the Quran, these type of things. As we get older, we become too embarrassed. We lack the humility to go to someone and say, please help me out here. I need help learning these things. So may Allah Ta'ala make it a success. Inshallah, there's going to be a very, you know, concentrated effort, inshallah, in bringing a very good system in which our children can enjoy coming to Maktab. That's one of the main things we want. We want our children to enjoy it, but also, inshallah, an environment where they'll learn and become very, very successful in their learning as well. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah Ta'ala bless all of you for joining the program.